What up, agents? Prime here. Yes, the Momentos Fury. This will be the meta build of TU11. Are you ready? Let's go! What up, guys? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content. Really appreciate you watching it. And today we're going to do it a little bit different. As we all know, the PTS is live, the test server, and I found me a build, man. Like we all know, that Hunter's Fury, like we saw, is going to be OP, and guys, it is OP. And then combine it with the Memento backpack, man, this is just straight face tanking everything. Just like you see, I'm running through a heroic mission and just clapping enemies left and right. Picking up the trophies to give me that extra armor, giving that extra weapon damage, even to get the toughest enemies out of the way. And guys, let me show you some gameplay and then let's dive into the build. And this is the build, guys. Of course, with the gunner specialization for that armor on kill. Rocking that Lady Death. Going with the new named shotgun, the MOP, because it mops up everyone. This is very, very nice gun, especially with the new special attribute on there, 5% armor on kill, and we can even roll another talent on there. So this can be a very, very good shotgun for in the future, guys. And then, of course, I went with the 4 pieces of Hunter Fury, and I went with the Memento backpack and with the new vest, Bellstone Armory, and of course with Intimidate on there. And why did I choose it this way? Because guys, this new gear set is just freaking overpowered. This is so much fun to play with. If you didn't know it yet, 2 pieces will give you 15% shotgun and SMG damage, 3 pieces 20% armor on kill and 100% health on kill, and then the 4 piece will activate the Apex Predator. Enemies within 15 meters receive a debuff, increasing your weapon damage against them by 20%, and that debuff is very, very nice. This gives us the opportunity to face tank the even heroic enemies. After killing a debuffed enemy with your weapon, disorients other enemies within 5 meters and amplifies your weapon damage by 5% for 10 seconds, stacking up to 5 times. So if they are running out in a group, what is happening, of course, in a lot of missions, then just shred them and you will get multiplicative damage and you will just shred everything in front of you. This is so freaking nice. Of course, I went for the weapon core, weapon damage, and then critical hit chance or critical hit damage rolled on there. As you can see, my critical hit chance mod is only 4.3% because I'm almost never on PC, only on the PTS, and we didn't get a full stack of a shade level or whatever. Everything needs to be maxed out, in my opinion, if you really need to test it. So let me show you the stats. Look at this, 53% critical hit chance and 75% critical hit damage. This isn't that high. And then, of course, not having that extra armor, not having that extra everything from my watch. As you can see, I'm only at level 9. But still, just like you see in the gameplay, this build shreds. There is a lot of min-maxing going on. You can do a lot better than this build right now. Over to the Bellstone Armory. I chose for this for that armor regeneration. And then, of course, the armor core. I went for the 2 armor cores to get a little bit more tanky, but still having that 5 red core. Yes, we have 5 red cores, but I will come to that in a second. This is a vest that I could buy. That's why it's repair skills on there. Again, we can do whatever on there. We can get some armor regeneration a second, or get your crit chance a little bit higher, of course. Pushing to that 60% is always good. And I went for Intimidate. While you have a bonus armor, amplifies total weapon damage by 35% to enemies within 10 meters of you. So this is very, very nice because we are running that Memento backpack. And this Memento backpack, man, this is gonna be a lot of fun. But guys, remember, it's still PTS. There are a lot of changes coming. They're changing things in the game every day on the PTS. So we have to see until it comes out. But this combination is just deadly, guys. Face tank deadly. Heroics don't stand a chance. As you can see, it has 3 core attributes and not normal attributes. So we have 15% weapon damage, 170k armor, and a skill tier, of course, because I have it maxed out. The attribute could be, of course, better, but that's the mod. And then over to the kill confirmed, and this makes this build so freaking powerful. Enemies you kill drop a trophy on death. Collecting trophies provides both a short and long-term buff, the first of which scales with the number of core attributes equipped and lasts 10 seconds. So we're getting an extra weapon damage, extra bonus armor, and extra skill efficiency for whatever we are rocking. As we can see, we are rocking a 5-core red and 2 blues, because we have a red from the memento and a blue for the memento. And then of course that yellow. So if we're going back to that talent of memento, that will give us 25% extra weapon damage, 40% extra bonus armor, and a 5% extra skill efficiency. And that's for every 10 seconds if you pick up a trophy. And that refreshes. It's so freaking nice. Of course, with that combination of intimidate, if you have bonus armor, your weapon damage gets multiplied by 35% within the 10 meters. We need to be close to pick up the trophies on death, of course, and we need to be close with the Hunter Fury to get that disorient or even that multiplicative damage that gives us within 5 meters. So this whole build boosts each other so freaking hard. And then after that, for every trophy collected, gain an additional 1% weapon damage, 1% skill efficiency, and 0.1% armor regeneration for 300 seconds. Max second 30, so we only have to pick up 30 trophies, gives us a 30% extra weapon damage, 30% extra skill efficiency, and 3% armor regeneration for 300 seconds. Again, coming up to all this damage, guys, this is just so freaking insane. I chose for the balls to know where they are because I'm always running around, of course, with the Lady Death combination. You could go for the backfire, it's a very nice one as well, but then make sure that you go for some hazard protection or go for the ninja bike knee pads. That will make sure that you don't bleed if reloading, or yeah, of course, jumping over an obstacle to reload. But that Lady Death also gives us, of course, the stacks with the breathe free that everybody knows. And man, just like you saw, this is gonna be the new meta, guys. And just like I said, my watch level isn't that high. I don't have any points in my gunner specialization, so I don't have that extra SMG damage. I only went for that armor on kill and of course that med kit, because if you're not sure to get your kill because you need to be up and close, you could use your med kit, because this med kit also gives us a extra bonus armor, so that will activate intimidate and you will have that extra multiplicative damage to an enemy within 10 meters. And yeah, guys, this is so much fun to play with. Just like I showed you, this isn't even maxed out. We can hit a lot more. We can have a lot more survivability if we have a little bit more armor from, of course, our watch. But guys, man, this is going to be the go-to build for the summit and even for the heroic gameplay, just like I showed you in the beginning. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much it for today. My first PTS build. Hopefully they don't change too much for the drop. But thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course the notification bell. Pure Prime out.